just heard the most fascinating.
Augusta's safe house was destroyed by the Institute.
It's as I feared. Three safe houses gone. Hard to imagine.
I have nothing further for you at the moment. I'm sure someone else could use your help. No shortage of fires to be put out.
Hey, Doc.
I still can't believe Dez assigned you to our HQ.
Is it really that unusual?
In my years of service, no one's ever just joined HQ straight away. True, you finding us in the first place was singular. But, put simply, you shouldn't be here. It isn't a question of competence, it's a simple matter of security.
And I'm going to compromise your security... how?
Deacon's assurances aside, we don't know you, so your trustworthiness is up for discussion. Brushing that aside, before anyone joins HQ, they've usually spent years in the field. But you, you're dangerously ignorant of our procedures, our protocols. Since you're one of us now, might as well try to keep you alive. If you need patching up, see me.
What type of doctor are you?
My specialty is need to know and all that. However, I assure you I can treat any ailments or wounds you're likely to encounter. Word to the wise, be prepared to improvise. You may find your operational orders lacking.
You're obviously one of the smartest people here. What do you really mean by that?
No one doubts Desdemona is, inspirational. But let's just say strategy may not be her forte. When planning a mission, a certain degree of clinical detachment can be invaluable.
I can see that.
Focus on the objective. Everything else is just a distraction. Good luck.
Hey, Doc.
Are you injured? It's a wonder you and Glory don't set off metal detectors.
What's new, Doc?
Been out of the loop. Lots of sick and injured taking up my time. Now, if you need treatment, let me know.
Patch me up, Doc.
Now go over your symptoms for me, one at a time.
Feel better now that I'm cleaned up.
Glad to hear it. Anything else?
Just hurt all over.
Gonna need to brace those fractures. Apply some cream for the burns, a few sets of stitches. Better get to it. And that's that. Anything else bothering you?
That was it.
All right. Don't ruin my hard work by dying out there.
How do you even fit down here? I just heard the most fascinating rumor. The story goes that you actually found the Institute. been there and back again. Sounds crazy, right?
Where'd you hear that?
Deacon brought it to my attention. And, as usual, he won't give up his source.
It's all true.
Deacon says you used teleportation. I can't imagine. We know you got inside with the help of the Brotherhood of Steel. My hope is you've infiltrated them for us. Or, at the very least, your true loyalty lies with us. So let's put it to the test. We have a vital mission that only you can carry out. You up to it?
Why should I help you instead?
Now that the Brotherhood knows where the Institute is, in time, they will mount an offensive. And once they do, they'll slaughter everyone in the Institute. Men, women, children, and every synth they can find. I respect you far too much to believe you'd participate in such a bloodbath.
I'll do the mission then.
You have no idea how relieved I am to hear that. What I'm about to tell you is the most closely guarded secret the Railroad has. It's time you learn about Patriot. There's a man, or woman, we're not sure, inside the Institute, who helps synths escape to freedom. Dozens of synths owe him their lives. We don't know his name. We've never had a way to contact him. So we gave him the code name Patriot. So you need to infiltrate the Institute and make contact with Patriot.
How do I make contact?
Tom devised a way to send a message to Patriot. We can plant a coded message on an Institute terminal. And if all goes well, he'll respond. Just see Tom, and you can proceed from there.
Oh, man, you were actually there? Inside the belly of the beast?
No time for that, though. Let's set you up to contact Patriot.
I got here one genuine Tinker Time special. Just load her up onto a holotape, plug her into any Institute terminal, and execute.
Thank you.
Got it.
The airport. Can we fly to Los Angeles? I hear it is most lovely there.
Proctor Ingram?
That's all four actuators. Delivered and done. Nice work.
Right on schedule. I've completed the restoration of Prime's basic functions, and he's ready to go. In fact, it's getting difficult to explain to the system why it can't move right now.
Well, as soon as my scribes get those actuators in place, we'll have his arms and legs installed in no time. Which brings me to your next assignment. It won't be long before Prime can walk and talk, but he's missing one last important element. His nukes. Without them, his offensive systems aren't operating at peak capacity.
What's Prime armed with?
Prime has two weapon systems, his eye laser and his nuke pack. The eye laser can target a hostile from hundreds of yards out and take it down with pinpoint accuracy. His nukes are modified Mark 28 nuclear bombs. They used to drop the things from bombers during the war. Just one of the nukes is equivalent to about three or four Fat Man shells. Basically, whatever it hits isn't getting up again. His eye laser is almost ready to go, but without nukes to load into his pack, he's fighting at less than half his capability.
I'll run down to the Super Duper Mart and pick some up.
Cute. I wish it was that simple. Prime's bomb pack is fitted for Mark 28 nuclear bombs, the same type of bombs that were dropped from aircraft during the Great War. The Commonwealth was a major staging area for the military's Air Force, so we assumed we wouldn't have trouble finding them. But since we arrived, our scouting teams haven't located a single bomb.
That's going to be a problem. Without a fully loaded nuke pack, Prime won't have the firepower to take on the Institute.
Can I build the nukes like I built the actuators?
I could build you 1,000 nuke casings, right now. But we've got nothing to put inside them. The Mark 28s have a specialized nuclear payload that requires the correct balance of fissile materials in order for them to detonate properly. In other words, I'd love to mix you a cocktail, but I'm all out of liquor. But before you give up hope, there's actually a silver lining here. Proctor Quinlan has located some records regarding a military installation, which was used as a nuclear weapons storage facility. We're fairly certain this included a stockpile of the Mark 28s. The catch is that the installation is located somewhere within the glowing sea.
Sounds like that's our only option.
Yep. I only wish I had better information for you, but that's all we have to go on. Scribe Halen's established a communications point on the frontier of the glowing sea. I suggest you head out there first and establish a signal protocol with her so that the nukes can be airlifted out once you've located them. Hopefully, by the time you've returned, we'll be ready to wake Prime up and you can say hello. Good luck, Knight.
Rearming Prime with nukes should get him back to full fighting potential.
Welcome. Do you require additional supplies?
Let's see what you have.
Thank you.
Good to see you.
Hello, Father. Tell me, what would you do when someone has stolen from you?
That's a loaded question. What's been stolen from you?
Institute property is not often taken from us. We cannot react lightly when it happens. The group that calls themselves the Railroad have acquired several synths from the Institute. Synths that had gone missing in recent months. They no doubt mean to free these synths, in their delusion that synths are somehow sentient beings. You've been in contact with the Railroad, so you're aware of their misguided beliefs.
What happened? What have they done?
They are in possession of technology that does not belong to them. Usually they are a minor nuisance, but lately they have become more emboldened. I'm afraid we've reached the point where a response is necessary. We have learned the current location of these synths and need to reacquire them before the Railroad can hide them.
Where are the synths located?
A small settlement at the old Bunker Hill Monument. But it's important that we act on this soon, before the Railroad has any indication we've tracked them. We also don't want the Brotherhood of Steel getting wind of the presence of the synths. That would only complicate matters.
Is it just me, or will I have backup?
Of course, sir. We'll be waiting for you outside Bunker Hill. You'll have support should you need it. But we want to keep this small.
synth unit. You were scheduled for maintenance duty in SRB last night. Anything you'd like to report?
Nothing to report, sir.
It's me. So you're the one who sent the encrypted message. How did you even do that? I wasn't sure anyone on the surface would have a chance to crack Trinity. You know, the encryption algorithm.
Yes.
Trinity?
No.
What's that?
Trinity is an encryption system with a cipher, or key cut up into many pieces. You need several pieces in the correct order to unlock it. I put a Trinity piece with every synth I helped escape. It was a long shot, but I was hoping some good Samaritan would connect it all together.
Who are you?
I'm Liam Binet. My father runs synth development, and everyone knows who you are.
A friend named Tinker Tom cracked your encryption.
He must have had some serious hardware to pull that off. Wow, your message was only one word. Friend. What did you mean by that?
What do you think?
At the very least, I'm hoping it means you won't turn me in. But you really are a friend, aren't you?
The railroad sent me to look for someone they call Patriot. That's you.
What? The railroad? As in the railroad. And they gave me a code name too? I kept sending synths to the surface hoping someone would help them. I hoped the railroad got to some of them, but I never knew for certain.
How did you help synths escape?
Through hacking. The departments focus their best talents on hard science. Why waste time on terminal security, right? The SRB is the exception, and unfortunately, they control which synths go to the surface. But a forged work order from, let's say, Bioscience can get a hand-picked synth on surface detail. And it turns out the railroad was waiting for them. Wow.
Why are you helping synths?
At first, I just wanted to see if I could get away with it. It was a challenge, you know? But then I realized the synths are really just like us, except without any freedom. I decided to help the ones that wanted to escape so they can have a better life.
Saved a lot of synths.
So much to take in. But wait, with you in the picture, I have this idea to rescue a lot of synths at once. But we'll need help. Where's he working now? Right, let's go to the West Atrium. Probably best to talk about something else right now. You know my father thinks it's a living hell on the surface, but that can't be right. Heck, you look positively normal to me. No offense. I'm not sure if we could ever make the surface actually a decent place to live, but that doesn't mean we shouldn't at least try to help, you know? C-114. It's me.
Sir, do you require something?
It's okay, Z-1. He's a friend. He's with the railroad.
Leaving here is dangerous. And you bring a stranger. You. How do I know we can trust you?
Because the members of the railroad have dedicated their lives to fight for your freedom.
I thought only Mr. Binet cared. But your friends actually fight for us?
That's what the railroad does, Z-1. He's from the surface.
I've never met another human willing to help. But, sir, we must make this quick.
Right now. How many synths want to escape, Z-1?
The ones I know for certain? 13.
That'll take forever. Let's free those 13 all in one go.
I would do anything for my people. But how do we get them to the teleporter? It's no good. The old maintenance tunnels that lead there are always sealed. By the SRB.
If I can find a way to open those doors, could you get your synths to the teleporter room?
Yes. We'll talk later. Someplace more secure.
Just a few high security doors, right? Controlled by cutting-edge SRB security tech. Yeah. A head-on hack is the sucker play. So we go at them sideways. You're willing to help, right? I can't do this alone.
Of course I'll help you.
Our core security architecture hasn't fundamentally changed from the old CIT days. The original security program was called Code Defender. revolutionary stuff. We still have terminals running version 1, mothballed in storage. With some persuasion, I can get an old terminal to interface with the new security terminals. Enough to open doors, at least. Problem is, I can't even crack version 1. So I need a good old-fashioned username and a password. And that's nowhere to be found in the Institute. But if you could get me a pre-war admin password from the surface, I could log right in.
Where would I find that?
Unfortunately, I don't know. The obvious place won't work. The CIT ruins were picked clean years ago, but some of the admins had to live off campus. Ask your friends in the railroad. I need those login credentials.
But something so big. I can't ask people to keep it secret any longer. The rumor is true. One of our agents has made it inside the Institute.
Is this what Tinker Tom was working on?
Yes, Tom's work is related. But the device and the assembly was the Wanderer's doing. After the device was assembled, he made it inside the Institute. And then back out.
Where is the Institute?
We're not sure exactly. Best guess is that it's somewhere under the old CIT. But they've been using a teleportation device to get in and out, so it could be anywhere.
What did he find out?
I know you all have questions, but I've said everything I'm going to. But know this, the ops you're planning and running now are the most important of our lives. We have a chance at rescuing more synths than we ever dreamed of, so get it done.
Hey, it's the professor. The professor's back.
Doc Carrington's been asking for you.
The importance of Bunker Hill and our asset there is not widely known. Please keep it that way.
Can I talk to you?
Something on your mind?
Any news on your side?
Things we've set in motion continue to move. There are complications, always are, but nothing worth bringing to your attention. How about you? Any news?
The Institute knows about Bunker Hill. They're planning to recapture the synths there.
The timing couldn't be worse. The old man's been sitting on those four synths. There's nowhere else that's safe we could put them. Maintaining your cover is vital. But this, the sacrifice is just too great.
How much damage would it cause if we let them hit us?
We're running out of places to hide our synths. That's why we put so many eggs in one crowded basket to begin with. So what would we lose? Four synths? Stockton, some of our best agents, and the inevitable civilian casualties? No, not this time. We've never known when and where the Institute would strike us next, but now we have a chance to turn the tables. We wait until the enemy is in position, then we hit them hard. No one they send out comes back alive except you. Understand?
Won't the Institute be suspicious if I'm the only one left?
You're a lot tougher than anyone else in their outfit. If only one person could survive, it would be you. And any story you come up with won't be contradicted. We can't attack too early. We need to draw them into the kill zone and then spring the trap. You'll know when. You'll probably have a Corsair escort. You'll have to take them down. You've done it before, but it'll still be dangerous.
Taking down a Corsair on top of everything else? It's too much.
It's a risk, but it's one we have to take. So get it done.
Desdemona.
Have you met with Patriot yet?
was the plan again?
Tom encrypted a holotape using the same encryption scheme Patriot used in the past. If you put that holotape on any terminal down there, hopefully you'll get his attention. Or have you already met him?
I met Patriot. His name is Liam Binet.
I knew you'd get the job done. We need every scrap of intel you picked up in there. Write up a full report on Pam's terminal. After you're done, we'll analyze it and figure out the next step. Get to it.
Up top, you gotta be careful.
Confirmed. Agent Professor has... Solution. A new distribution center needs to be established.
A distribution center? What's that?
The railroad organization calls distribution centers safe houses. A place where synths are stored and then rerouted safely through the region known as mission details. Commence. Pacify the target location. Fortify position to protect current and future railroad assets. New distribution center will be co-
Damn it. Losing Augusta is a real blow. Not your fault, I know.
Pam.
Preliminary analysis complete.
Anything we need?
I hope that you take that armor to some odd covert
Bunker Hill! I so wanted to visit. Do they have tools?
Thank you.
I've been waiting for you.
Watch your tone, Synth.
Next time, move faster. Our targets are inside. 4 synths under railroad protection. Majority of the settlement is uninvolved and are expected to run for cover. The situation appears to have escalated. A covert approach is likely impossible. The mission's parameters just changed. We're going shooting. Requesting backup relay now.
Thank you.
What's that noise?
I've got money. It's yours if you let me go.
What's this about money?
Yes, money. Here. 60 caps. That's all I've got. We're good, right?
F-633 initiating reset. Authorization code Delta-62 Arcus.
Here they are.
God, it's a Courser.
Oh, no.
Issue the reset codes and we'll relay back to the Institute. Time is critical.
There, Synth.
Come on, please. Just don't.
Damn it. Where'd you...
Why are you so afraid?
I don't want to go back. Please, don't make me go back.
B-257, initiate reset. Authorization code Theta-93 Stratus. Alright, Synth.
Please!
You're safe. Calm down.
You're not going to send me back?
I cannot allow you to set these synths free. You will be terminated and your actions will be reported.
There is a lot more of it that we are gonna bear on you.
As soon as you're gone. We'll get somewhere safe as soon as you're gone.
Still in one piece.
You've given us another chance at life. We won't forget it.
Got company.
You mess with one of us, you mess with all of us.
The good karma's paying off.